Hello everyone, how are you? In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to animate Libisco's Realm and Guillaume Cruikshank. In the first video, I showed you some techniques, and in today's video, I'm gonna show you these other techniques. And make sure to stick till the end because I'll give you some tips on how to dissect the rest of Bisco's and Guillaume's animation techniques. First, let's replicate these effects. Add a Bezier curve. In edit mode, scale and rotate and put it where you want the path to be. I'm gonna extrude in the y-axis because here is where I want the animation to end. Add a curve modifier. Apply scale and location. And subdivide to give this wobbly effect to the object. In edit mode, move the curve so the object sits in the right place. Let's keyframe the location in the last frame. And in the first frame, let's move it to the beginning. Make a location keyframe. Change the scene mode. In theory, we have the effect, but what if we'd wanted to add a twist to the object as well? Add a simple deform modifier. Let's move it to the top. You could play with the limits, but I want the object to bend towards the middle, so I need to change the origin. And now it does bend towards the middle, but of course we need to move the curve now. I'm gonna do that in a second. Let's make a keyframe. Move to the end, put 0 and make a keyframe. In edit mode, just place the curve. Let's correct this. Make a location keyframe. Move the curve again in edit mode. We could move the simple deforms keyframes. Gonna lock the location keyframes. Okay, this looks pretty good, so let's move on to the next effect. Let's make these animated kitchen cabinets. Add two shape keys, put one as the value, Let's make some drawers. Insert, make sure individual is enabled. And extrude towards the inside of the object. Insert but not as individual faces. Let's copy this value. Let's do the other one. Paste the value. And now select all these and extrude. See how this works? We need to rotate it for sure. So once the object is in its final location, set the value as 0 and make a keyframe. Move to a different frame, set this one as 1 and make a keyframe. Let's move the shape keys keyframe and change the easing mode. As you can see, we have a problem here. When the object is twisted, it touches the floor. I tried moving the curve in edit mode, but I was making things more complicated. So I made a new Bezier curve. Scale it. Move it in edit mode. Gonna rotate this control point and move it. Extrude in the y-axis. Choose the new curve as the curve object. Apply rotation. In edit mode, move and rotate the curve. As you can see, I still have this problem with the twisted object touching the floor. So I'm gonna use the Delta Transform, not the Transform. Go to the keyframe where the object is touching the floor. Move the Delta Transform until it doesn't touch the floor anymore. Make a keyframe. Go to the end. Move the Delta Transform down. And make a keyframe. I'm gonna move the last Delta Transform keyframe. I'm gonna correct the location keyframe a bit. So for the windows, first let's do the holes. Let's make a different shape. Select all the shapes, make a scale keyframe for all these three shapes. Now go to the beginning and choose individual origins. Scale 0 and make a scale keyframe. Change the easy mode. And now let's add one Boolean modifier for each shape. So here we have the base for our windows. And remember to make the objects invisible in renders. Now let's make a different window shape. Edit mode, edge select, and bevel. Move your mouse wheel or just put the number of segments here. Let's add a boolean in the other wall. And this one is already animated because we duplicated the cube that was already animated. Now for the window frame. Duplicate. Scale in the X axis. In face select mode, let's select both faces and insert. In edge select mode, move the edges on both sides. delete faces in edge mode. Select both edges and fill. Let's repeat. Make sure you select the right edges. These keyframes came from duplicating the cube that was animated, so delete them. Go to a frame where the booleans are completely animated. Make a location and rotation keyframe and make a scale keyframe. Go to a different frame, move and rotate the window frame. Make a location and rotation keyframe and a scale 0, make a scale keyframe. And there you have it. Change the easy mode. And if we put all the effects together, we've got our animation. You can change the keyframes. For example, for this window, I delayed these windows keyframes. You can download the blend file for free, and you can also support the channel leaving a tip on my Ko-fi profile or through PayPal. I already talked about some Viscose Realms techniques in the first video, like the plugin he uses, for example. So now I want to give you some tips about these two artists' style and how to break it down. I recommend you download their animations and watch them frame by frame. Some objects appear out of the blue, but because the animation is fast, you can see them. You can try different keyframe types as well to give an attitude to the movement, like a bounce effect, for example. Viscose Realm stylizes movement, meaning he gives these objects a cartoony motion by twisting or shrinking them before they fall onto their place. Okay, so that's it for today's video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!